Bill and Tracy, we have your transmission disassembled and laid out on the bench here, and I'll show you what we found and give you a list of the parts we need to get you repaired and get you back on the road with our 5-year, 50,000-mile warranty. The first thing is right here. This is your pan, and as you can see, the fluid in here, on a scale of 1 to 10 on contamination, this is about a 10. You can see the buildup in here, and you can see the color, how it's like a brown, rusty color. And this, on the bottom here, you can see how bad that is. Those are actually stuck to the side. And this is a rust color. And the fluid here is, you can see the fluid, how dark and brown it is, and then just very severe. That's scraping that off there. So you can see how bad it is. And what happened is, this is throughout your transmission with this contaminated fluid, and I'll tell you why in just a bit, how, you know, why it's contaminated. You can see how the bearings came apart in there. They're missing. You can see there's one here, but that one's gone. That one's gone. That just came apart. Now this here is your clutch. This is supposed to have some lining on it. If we look at these here, you can see the lining on this one. At least there's some of this left here on that brown. This is metal. It's completely gone. Just gone. And you can see how it cut into the metal. So this clutch is supposed to have lining on each side. And then this is your gear. And it was metal on metal. So it's completely tore up. And if you look, there's these little areas of rust buildup. See that in there? It's on just about every part. You can see it here also. This is from inside your transmission. You can see a little bit of rust buildup on there. Some more there. That'll focus there for you. You can see that. So your electronics are contaminated. And your torque converter's contaminated over here. And there's only one way for fluid to get in and out of there, so it's not possible to flush it all out and clean it all out. So what happened here, Bill and Tracy, I'm going to show you. Now we pan over the other side of our work area here. You can see this is our test kit for engine coolant. Now your transmission cooling lines go, it runs through the radiator and comes back and it actually cools the oil. But coolant got in there. So something's going on with your radiator causing coolant to get in there, and that's what happened. You can see this is our test tube laying there on top, and you can see that top part's purple, so you can see it failed the test, meaning there's a severe amount of engine coolant in your transmission fluid, and that's the cause of failure there. So we're going to put together an estimate for parts and labor. And then I'll show you how we're going to, we're going to flush out your system. But with the problem there, we've got to make sure your lines are flushed out. But we've got to find out what happened, what's going on inside your radiator to enable this coolant to get in there, which caused the failure of your transmission. So we'll put together an estimate for parts and labor and get you repaired and get you back on the road. Thanks, Tracy, Bill. Here's an example of for lack of a better term, a healthy transmission. You can see how clear the fluid is, and there's no sludge buildup on the bottom of the pan. And here's the magnet. There is some on the magnet, but that's normal. You can see that there. But it's not all fuzzy, all the shame. You can see there's just no sludge in the bottom of the transmission. The fluid's clear. So our example of a healthy transmission. Certified Transmissions, Draper, Utah.
Okay, this is our hot flush machine, and it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be, and this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does, this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now, it's only at about 179 degrees. and it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now, it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now, this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. But let's see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. This is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. But that's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.